This is quite exciting. I like the energy in this room. I'd like to start by congratulating all of you. You have done well. ,000 of you applied and 1,000 chosen, and you all made it. Congratulations. I want you to embrace hard work. Hard work is very important for success in entrepreneurship. No compromise, you have to work hard. And as they say, even they tell us when we're growing up that hard work doesn't kill. Indeed, it does not kill. So please try as entrepreneurs, don't be lazy, try to work extra hard and make sacrifices and work hard, you know, work hard towards realizing the purpose that you set for yourself. Number two, you have to be very disciplined. Discipline is key for success in everything, but more importantly, in business. You have to be extremely disciplined. You know, there are times we wake up in the morning, ideally if I had my way, I wouldn't like to go to work, but you can't afford not to go to work. And the fact that you're an entrepreneur, your own business director, leader, does not mean that you should have double standards. You should say something and do a different thing. So you need to lead by example. Anyway, discipline is extremely important in all its ramifications. Discipline, very good. Three, you need to think long term. Think long term as entrepreneurs. So thinking long term means you have to forego some short term gains for the future. Always think long term, because in the long term, that's when you actually create significant value, both economic and social value. So think long term. You are an entrepreneur, it's a long journey, and keep thinking and keep visualizing yourself in the long run. In 20 years and this will happen. It is that long term vision that puts you and makes you want to achieve more. Of course, you need to dream dreams. I say to people a lot, you need to dare to dream. You know, so when the young man told me about the airplane, if I was not a trained entrepreneur or an experienced entrepreneur, I could easily have said to him, keep quiet, why are you thinking of airplane? But these things do happen. You know, these things do happen. Have the dream first. The next thing, ask yourself, what do I need to do to orchestrate this dream, to make it happen? Then realistically go about those things and then set milestones for yourself, realizing that you can't just suddenly get to from A to B without making some steps. So milestones, dream, have milestones, ask yourself realistically what you need to do, commit to hard work, discipline yourself, go after it, you will succeed. Then saving, you need to try to save, you know, try to save. You know, don't consume everything they want. You need to save for capital formation. And you need capital to make investments. So one of the reasons small businesses fail is people just get money and the next thing they start doing things that can be deferred. So don't consume immediately. Try to make some sacrifices, forgo certain things, and in the long run, you'll be better for it. And finally, two more things. For those of you who believe in partnerships or who have partnerships, I have an advice for you. Partnerships don't work a lot or well in our environment, Africa, but they do work and they can work. And so you should make it work. You're already in a partnership. But for your partnership to work, you need to close your ears to a lot. You know, people talk carelessly in our environment. So you need to close your ears to a lot of things. You need to look at the big picture. You need to share a common destiny with your partner or partners. You need to align your interests. You need to put issues on the table. Don't put things below the table. No, just don't skirt or run away from issues. Put issues up. This, for instance, when we started as Standard Trust Bank, two of our directors believed that we should share dividends every year. And I kept telling them that please, want this, recall this, what we committed to, want to do this, and to do this, we need to save money to do this, so we thought that we should not share dividends. But two of them said, Tony, we are 60-something years old, you're just 30-something years old. Please, we want to have dividend. But we came to a compromise that instead of maybe sharing 50%, we can share 10% and see save. But it was good that we put it on the table, we discussed it, so there's no tension at the board meeting unnecessarily. So always discuss issues with your partners. Discuss issues is always very, very good. And it helps you to align interests, understand where the other person is coming from, and try to sell your idea to that person or vice versa. Either you sell or you also listen. But what you must not compromise is the future of the business. What you must not compromise is the future of the business. It's about doing business in an ethical fashion. It's about making sure that the you don't consume everything you make day one. And finally, I like to advise, consistent with the Vice President's advice on integrity, I like to advise that let us always think of outcome. You know, if we think about outcome, about consequences, about accountability, then it will moderate what we do. There are a lot of things, even me, there are a lot of things you would like to do, but if you think of accountability, consequences, outcome, then you just moderate yourself. So imbibe this and it will help you as our future leaders, as the people we hope to help the African continent to move to the next level. We want to create ministry jobs out of you, and that's my prayer. When people would ask me, what is success to you here? I say, success to me here is that these people, these young African entrepreneurs, that they all succeed. As Aruma said, you list your companies, I want to see you create employment. I want to see you address some of our social issues on the continent. I want to see you lead by example. I want to see you help to catalyze different sectors. You know, we have opportunities here, and no one but ourselves will know these opportunities in all its entirety. So take advantage of this and note and know in everything you do that we have enormous opportunities on our continent. So many opportunities on this continent. So take advantage of this and don't be deterred by this feeling of the difficult operating environment that we have. We do have it. It's a rigidity that lives with us. And so ability to even navigate around it present on its own huge investment economic opportunities that you also should take advantage of.